For the Southern Minibus Association, business is extremely slow. The association says people are definitely not traveling as much as they did last Christmas season. The association believes this is due largely to an expected increase in the bus fare in January 2014. Southern Minibus drivers say commuters are watching their money in anticipation of the increase. Officials say in the first place, an increase to commuters was not what they requested. But the public relations officer of the Southern Minibus Association says it would have been better if consideration was given to providing drivers with subsidies rather than raise bus fares.
Today is the day before Christmas Eve, and what's the state of the, from morning, the motor people peg, that have left on the peg. Also, the people we saw on Saturday in Viewford and Gaswitz, they were not like the people you would expect to see. That's what I'm saying. I'm expecting a report from the business people. It's not as if the spirit of Christmas is not there, and people are scared of whatever they have that to remove it, because the ending of the year was so bad, they're not sure what is coming in January. So that is a problem we face. And as I said, I hope God will try and do a miracle that things pick up in St. Lucia, because otherwise, in the new year, I think it's going to be terrible. Very terrible. And I'm saying prior to that, too. Anyway, that one is for the new year. But prior to that, I hope the government and the minister responsible of consumer affairs and even the minister of finance try and get something in place. It's not good. Honestly, it's not good.
Just last week, according to the association's public relations officer, he received counterfeit money twice. Security on the buses is also an issue. The association says sometimes minibus operators get assaulted by commuters who overindulge in alcohol. The association also cited the problem of commuters ignoring the no eating and drinking signs on buses implemented by the Transport Ministry. In some cases, according to reports, passengers leave chicken boxes and other pieces of garbage under their seats, and officials say sometimes the operators get short-changed, and piracy, according to them, continues to be a problem.
We have buses from all other routes, buses without permits, those with specified permits, the taxi vehicles plying our route. Our route is the most vulnerable route. So what we would appreciate probably if the ministry could put something in place to protect us on our road, because it is unfair to us that we pay in our permit regularly and that we still have to compete with buses from other routes or buses without route permits and the taxi buses. This is my main concern right now.
Okay, now let me ask you, if people are finding it difficult now to pay the bus fare now, what do you think is going to happen in the new year when the prices increase?
Well, actually, it's not that difficult to pay, because I've been doing this for like 18 years. It's not a difficulty in paying. It's like when you come on the bus, like they don't take the bus as a business and they don't respect what you do. It's like bus drivers are nothing to them. It's not that they can't afford. They can, but they wish to just pay what they feel like. That's what it is. But to answer your question, I guess in the coming year, like I've heard that the bus fare might increase, I feel it will be a little difficult to the commuters to be able to pay the bus fare, because if you're working for the same salary, everything increases and your salary doesn't increase. It will be difficult to pay.
The Southern Minibus Association is hoping that some of the problems can be adequately addressed in the coming year. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.